स्टार्ट।
सो स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर द शहनाई ऑफ बिस्मिल्लाह खान। दिस चैप्टर इज डिवाइडेड इन टू पार्ट्स। नाउ आई एम मूविंग विद द सेकंड पार्ट। इन द सेकंड पार्ट राग काफी इज ए वेरी डिफिकल्ट राग फॉर ए म्यूजिशियन एंड ए शहनाई प्लेयर टू प्ले एंड उस्ताद बिस्मिल्लाह खान डिड दैट एट रेड फोर्ट when India got independence at 15th August 1947. Not only in India, Ustad Bismillah Khan was popular all over the world. He went to play his solo performance in Afghanistan, where the King Jahir Shah was so much inspired and so much enthralled by his captivating performance that he gave him his precious Persian carpet. If you know Persian carpets, they are worth in lakhs or even in crores. And then all over the world he was greatly means appreciated. And then even the Bollywood was also highly inspired by him. So especially director Vijay Bhatt was greatly inspired by him, and he made a movie on his Shehnai skills, Goonj Uthi Shehnai. And that picture was a mega hit, and in that picture a song of his Dil Ka Khilona Toot Gaya was such a nationwide blockbuster. It was a chart buster, and it was totally amazing that how Bismillah Khan can enthrall and captivate everyone with his Shehnai even in the Bollywood. Then in regional cinema in Kannada, that is the local cinema of Karnataka, in one of the ventures Sanidhi Aparna, you can read in the book also, Sanidhi Aparna, he has also given his music. But finally he maintained distance with the cinema because he used to say, I don't like all the pomp, show and artificiality of the cinema. After that, it was not only in India, not only abroad, everywhere he was very famous. And finally there was an auditorium in Iran which was named after Ustad Bismillah Khan. And then he went to the Western world, where he was the first person from India to play in the Lincoln Central Hall in USA. He was called in the World Exposition Center in Montreal, Canada, also in the Osaka Trade Fair, Japan. And I have already told you, Tehran Auditorium was named after him. In year 2001, he was awarded as the Bharat Ratan, the India's highest civilian award, where on his chest rests the Bharat Ratan, and with glitter in his eyes, and he was choking because he was overwhelmed by the emotion. He says to the Indian audience that, please teach Hindustani classical music to your kids, because this is the greatest and the richest tradition we have. Even the West is following that. Anywhere in the world he goes, but he misses two things the most. Firstly, River Ganges, Banaras, and his native place of Dumrau in Bihar. And one of his students in USA told him that he will create the exposition or will replicate the scenes of Ganga and everything in USA. But Ustad Bismillah Khan replied that, when I am in abroad, I think of Hindustan. When I am in Hindustan, Mumbai, I think of Banaras and the Holy Ganges. When I am in Banaras, I think of Mattha of Dumrau. Mattha is like lassi. So this was the great thing. And he was a devout Muslim. He used to pray 5 times a day. But still, he used to play daily at the world famous, the most sacred holy site for Hindus all over the world, at Kashi Vishwanath Temple. This shows that he was a great human. On 21st August 2006, he died after a prolonged illness. The state government of UP declared it as a state holiday, and even the central government in India was in deep mourning and declared it as a national sorrowful day. This was the full chapter of Ustad Bismillah Khan in two parts. I hope you understand it very well. If any doubt, any queries, you can revert back to me. Thank you. Have a nice day.